How are you? We're going to start with this preparation, getting to know Saint Joseph in these 30 days of accompaniment in his life. We're going to use the excerpts from the Mystical City of God, from Venerable Mary of Jesus of Agreda. This book has an imprimatur of in Santa Fe, Nuevo Mexico, in 1949 by Archbishop of Santa Fe, Edwin Byrne. And also, it has approvals by Pope Innocent XI in 1686, by Pope Alexander VIII, Clement IX, Benedict XIII, Bishop Ignatius Diocese of Regensburg in 1885, by Cardinal d'Aguirre, by the Archbishop of Salzburg, Franz Albert, by Dr. James Osoldi y Udave, Bishop of Tarazona in the Diocese of Tudela from 1911. It also has the imprimatur of the English translation by Bishop of Fort Wayne in 1912, Bishop Alerding. And it has a decree of the Congregation of Rites approved by Pope Benedict XIV and Pope Clement XIV. The process of canonization of Mary of Agreda was promoted by the Spanish bishops and other eminent men of the church after her death in 1666. She was declared venerable to pave the way and continue the process of beautification. Her body is incorrupt. So this is a gift, and it's a very important book. For our beloved founder, John Rick Miller. So we're going to start with the day number one, the wonderful espousal of Mary Most Holy with Saint Joseph. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. At the age of 13, and a half having grown considerable for her age, our charming princess, the purest Mary, had another abstract view of the divinity. In this vision, we can say that something similar happened to what the Holy Scriptures talk about Abraham when God asked him to sacrifice his beloved son Isaac, this son being his only hope. As distant as heaven is from earth, were the thoughts of Most Holy Mary from the plans which the Most High now made known to her by commanding her to accept a husband for her protection and company. Her desire and will during her life had been that during her life she would have no husband, and she constantly repeated and renewed the vow of chastity which she had taken at such a premature age. Her Majesty replied, "Mary, do not trouble your heart, for your resignation is acceptable to me, and my powerful arm is not subject to laws, but my disposition that will happen as it is the most proper thing for you." Consoled only by this vague promise of the Lord, Most Holy Mary recovered from her vision and returned to her ordinary state, while our Great Lady was vigilant in prayer, resigned with prudent sighs. God spoke in sleep to the high priest Saint Simeon and commanded him to arrange the marriage of Mary, the daughter of Joachim and Anne of Nazareth, for he held her in the great esteem, love, and care. The Lord instructed the priest to call together the other priests and learned persons and to tell them that this maiden was left alone and an orphan and that she did not desire to be married, but that as it was a custom for the firstborn maidens not to leave the temple without being provided for, it was proper she should contract nuptials with whom they thought would be the ideal for her. The most prudent virgin, with a countenance of virginal modesty, answered the priest with great composure and humility. Sir, as far as my inclinations are concerned, I desire to preserve perpetual chastity throughout my life, for I wish to dedicate myself to God in the service of this holy temple in response to the great blessings received in it. I never had the desire to enter into marriage, since I considered myself incapable of carrying out the duties involved. This was my inclination, but you, my teacher, who are to me in God's place, will teach me what goes according to His holy will. My daughter, the priest answered, your desires are acceptable to the Lord, but remember that no maiden of Israel abstains from marriage as long as we expect the coming of the Messiah according to the divine prophecies. Therefore, all who receive the blessing of having children among our people should be considered happy and blessed. In the marital state, you can serve God truly and with great perfection, and in order that you may obtain a companion according to the heart of God and someone who is according to your wishes, we will pray to the Lord